If you've just gotten a new puppy or dog, today's Love Your Pet is about why you should take your new pet to a veterinarian. Dr. Richard Fujie from the King Street Pet Hospital joins us now. And who is this cutie?
This is Honey Bell. She's from Kaimuki. Floyd and Lynn Murashi owns her. And she's a year and a half miniature dachshund.
She is adorable and she's so well-mannered.
Yes, she's sweet.
So tell us, when people get a new dog or a puppy, you're advising or reminding them, take it to the vet.
Right. As soon as you adopt or purchase a dog, you should take it to the vet. And the reason why, we look for congenital problems. Also, we do testing for intestinal parasites. And then we also do a lot of client education on preventative medicine.
What are some of the common parasites or diseases or, you know, that you find?
Hookworms, roundworms, coccidia, giardia are common parasites we see. Roundworms is the main one we worry about, because that one can be transmitted to humans and can cause blindness in children. And so we want to test and also put them on a heartworm prevention medication that contains anti-roundworm, hookworm medication too.
Okay. And there's a lot of people who are multi-pet households, so it's probably, in the end, not just prudent, but saving yourself more money, right?
Right. So if a dog has parasites, you know, you adopt it, take it to your home, and it might transmit it to your other dogs. And so we want to treat them right away and take care of the problems.
I have to ask, when pets come from a breeder or the Humane Society, are they generally, you know, looked over? Do they come clean?
Yeah, usually most breeders will have the dogs vaccinated and tested beforehand. But with parasites, sometimes, you know, we do a series of stool checks, because the first test may be negative, the second one may be positive. So we do a series of testing.
What are the biggest problems that you usually find? I mean, I know you listed what is common, but, you know.
For congenital problems, usually like knee problems is probably the most common. You know, we call it medial patellar luxation, where the kneecap slides to the inside. That's very common in toy breeds.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Dr. Richard Fujie from the King Street Pet Hospital.